Yo, what's up? It's the Dark Horse here. Welcome. We're going to be playing Pokemon Fire Red Randomizer Nuzlocke. We're going to work through all the, obviously, gens and obviously just produce Pokemon content. And then, you know, I live stream those. So, yeah, I live this stream this live over on my main channel, the Dark Horse Play. So, if you're interested in obviously checking stuff out over there, be sure to subscribe to that one too. It's entirely your call. But anyway, first things first, I'm going to be a boy and I'm going to name him after me, Dark. And then we'll be on our journey. Honestly, there's something about the nostalgic old school Pokemon games that I really do love. And obviously, whenever we do play this, I do name our rival after my son, because he has to learn the hard way. But yeah, eventually our team will appear at the bottom, obviously, when we acquire some Pokemon. And let's see. Okay, so we do have a randomized item in storage, which is a magnet. Wow, okay. Okay. Well, we could take it. We never know. We might get an electric type, maybe, if we're lucky. If we do, then obviously we'll come back for the magnet. But other than that, here we go. Oak. Hey, wait. Come back. You need your own Pokemon for your protection. I know. Here, come with me. Alright. This is where, well, Pokemon Yellow is when my journey begun in the world of Pokemon. And over the years, I've kind of, you know, when you used to play the game, you'd not bother with typing. You just level up your Pokemon as high as possible and then just attack them with any move. So, yeah. I think in this, I've added... Oh, no, no. I think it's just a randomizer Nuzlocke then. No way! Okay, Poopitar, Hitmonlee. Well, I've got to go with my mascot, you know what I mean? Big up Gengar. That's fitting, you know what I mean? You know, we never know, we may lose. Hopefully we don't. We can name this one after me. Some members have assigned mascots. Christiana has Vulpix, Trophy has Eevee, Creed has Psyduck, Ben has Beldum, but I don't think Beldum will be in this one, so... Yeah, we'll name him after something random. I think we're good. Obviously, we're going to have to battle him. I'm not sure entirely if it's randomized. But yeah. I will check the ability of Gengar because it could be pretty decent. Oh. Actually, I think Sia will only have... Is it Headbutt? I can go Hypnosis. Yeah, this is going to be a very long Pokemon battle. I'm just trying to think. Obviously, I could go Spite, but I obviously don't want to give him the idea. Oh, yeah. I don't really want to reduce him too much to struggle. So, as long as we keep putting it to sleep, we can actually benefit. Also, by winning, I need that extra cash, which will allow me to... Yeah, he does have Headbutt. Oh, but it doesn't affect because it's a normal type move, because I'm a bloody donkey, and I've just only just worked that one out, but yeah. I haven't only just worked that one out, but yeah. I mean, that might be his only move, so... I think we are good. Yeah, he ain't hitting me. What a start, eh? But here we go. So... Dark gained 106, which is fine. Grew me to level 6. I actually didn't expect to go up so many levels. Biker Ashton has been defeated. We got 80 bucks. Excellent. If you win, you get to battle with the trainers, blah, blah, blah. All right. So now we need to... Because we don't have Pokeballs yet, we may have an item on our Pokemon, though. So we'll check that out. We do. We have a Cherry Berry. And it's slight HP recovery in rain. It's not bad. We'll keep the Cherry Berry on him. There's no point not having it. But yeah. Okay, so we get a little rough idea of what possible encounters we have. We have a possible Diglett. Not bad. I don't want to level up too high because obviously I don't want it to be that we don't get the potion from this guy. And then, what I want to do is tech speed fast. It's weird because I've been doing a hardcore. It's. Oop. Yeah, we're playing Fire Red, aren't we? We go red. Alright, we good. Let's go. We got a little fair idea of what encounter. Well, you get quite a few encounters here anyway, so all we need to do is basically try and maintain. I think when I did my first ever Nuzlocke, which was Pokemon Heart Gold, I think Cabana was my starter. But yeah, I have Hypnosis, which benefits me as long as we don't have to fight. Oh, I don't even know why I'm healing. As long as we don't have to fight a fire type, we should be fine. We do get the hidden item up here, which could be very resourceful. Ether. I could sell it, get more Pokeballs, maybe more potions if needed, which is good. I think we'll be okay, I think. But then obviously I have a bad case of jinxing. But yeah. Okay, Oak's parcel from the Pokemon Mart clerk. We're going to head through. Let's see. What do we have? I jump over here, run through the grass. I'm just thinking, if you're watching this, let me know in the comments below what your favorite Pokemon is. Is this literally all that's in here? Is Cabana? Because I'm all for it, don't get me wrong, but at the same time, I wouldn't mind getting some. I'm in the wrong house, but she didn't give me it yet. We have to get the Pokedex. Not that I need the town map, but yeah. I think the hardest part of playing these kind of games is the rock tunnel. But yeah. All right. It's just the intro. This is probably the fastest Pokemon game there is when it comes to intro. Although Pokemon Black does start pretty quick. You know, you literally... Well, I think it's Pokemon Black 2. You spawn in with the starters literally right in front of you. Mm-hmm. Okay. In tough times, we may use speed up, but I'm going to try and keep this series to the minimum on speed up. But yeah, all right, here we go. Oh, this Zaren can't. The only problem is I'm weak. If it has, I don't know if it has. I don't know. We'll take a chance because I don't know exactly what moves it has at this point. I don't want it to have. Okay, it might just only have tackle then. I thought it was gonna have like some Psy Wave or something. That's fine. We'll get the hypnosis off, and then what I'll do is, because he can't hit me, we'll go lick. It doesn't affect him either, because I don't even know what. Wait, mate, we've either got to try and catch this with these five balls, or okay, we're good. Not bad. Spinder. Mm-hmm. No two Spinder are said to have identical patterns. It confuses foes with its stumbling motions. Cool. What should we call this one? I'm trying to think of... Let's call it Topo. Dragon Ball reference. And also, I was thinking of Spinning Top. And we'll check its ability. What do we have? Hurts to touch. It's not that bad. Yeah, we literally only have tackle on it. Gonna have to level up at some point as well. The only thing with these games, the XP share isn't a thing. So it's literally, mate. To be fair, we've had Pidgey in the past and it's not as good as you'd think it would be, like in newer gen. It's right, we'll just go get our encounters over this grass bit, and then we get the one at the top, and then we get Viridian Forest as well. But yeah, we should be good. Okay, here we go. Oh, wait. Let's go buy Pokeballs first. Oh. The thing that blows my mind most as well is the fact that Pokemon has changed so much. Like, compared to what I think I started in 1998, I've been playing Pokemon for 24 years. I think I normally go 10, get the Premier, buy 3 potions, and then buy 1 antidote. And then we run with that. Although, that Ether, I'm not going to need yet, but I don't know if it sells... it doesn't sell for a lot, it sells 600. Yikes, alright, we'll keep it. Times are hard, man. Credit crunch. Right. What are we looking at, Pokemon wise? I think we're good. Everything's healed. Dark's got his cherry berry. You know. Okay. What have we got? What have we got? Okay. Okay. I don't know if this is going to... Oh, well, I'm hitting the hypnosis on a decent basis, to be fair. I just got to hope that I'm able to... not hit it, but like... Okay. That's good. I can't hit it again because I'm going to kill the thing. So, I've got to hope... Dugtrio would be good. Like, if we can get Magnitude and maybe, obviously... I don't know, whatever else we can really run with. But if I can catch this, it would be great. Mugging me off here, mate. You're mugging me off. Come on. Just let me have what I need. I just want to catch it. Because obviously so far we have Spinder and obviously Gengar. But if we have Dugtrio, our team's pretty diverse as well. But then Brock, on the other hand, we don't really know what he's running. 1, 2, 3. Bruh, it's killing me. I think it's outrageous that I've had 3 knocks, I've had 2 knocks, and now I'm missing my hypnosis. And my accuracy has been dropped even more. This is fine. Right, Dugtrio, go to sleep. Go to sleep. Go Pokeball. Nice. That's what we like to see, mate. We like to see that. Right, the Dugtrio. Nice. Give it a name. We'll call it Tripnips. Tripnips. Alright, we good. What is Tripnips' ability, though? That's the real question. What do we have? Leave spores on contact. Well, as try attack. I don't know why it didn't use that. Man, that would have been... Oh, he wouldn't have been able to hit me with it. I don't like the fact that all my Pokemon seem to be having normal type moves. The only thing that I could really benefit off is Gengar. But if we go up against a ghost type and they outspeed, we are dead. We have to do some leveling up. The only thing is... Trying to think. Just trying to figure something out. If I do level caps, then I can do rare candies. That's what I'm possibly thinking to do. Nah, you know, we'll stick with a legit. We'll have our first series just straight up legit. No rare candies. If a mon dies, it dies. If it it's a standard Nuzlocke anyway, you know what I mean? So if the Pokemon dies, it gets boxed, and basically, yeah. All the rules are pretty much the same. Obviously, hardcore is where you can't heal in battle, can't switch out, it's set. Things like that, so I'll speed this bit up quick, and then we can get back into it. There we go. Okay. So these episodes are going to be Monday, Wednesday, Friday. That's going to be a permanent thing. I'm going to try and have videos recorded on a regular basis for you all. And constantly be uploaded. I have Machop. This was initially Cash's mascot. But hope Cash is doing well. Hope everything's going well for you, sir. Right, okay. I'm going to have to grind anyway. But instead of me grind... I don't know. Thing is, I'm so used to live streaming these that I don't really know how to not, because I don't really want to spend a whole episode like sat there grinding Pokemon, you know what I mean? But then also, if you use the rare candy, it can kind of mess up your bag in Fire Red and Leaf Green. But yeah, we've got a solid team though. Machop evolves at 28. Also, I have Force Evo 1. I think I've set it to 40. So that way, every... Okay, we're good. Mate, I'm pretty cracked. I'm not gonna lie. Okay, you're reducing my defense. Which means that... We've caught every encounter so far. So, if the we can get a really good mon in the forest encounter, it'll be pretty decent. I need an XP share. Yeah. We can find an XP share, mate. That'll be even better. Ready? 1, 2, 3. Cap. Nice. 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 Right. Superpower. What should we call this? Hench. I'm trying to think of a muscular person. I can't think of one. Just call him Hench. Hench, what's your ability, sir? And you have an item. Trades accuracy for power. That's a typical henchy thing to do. And then we'll just take the item. PM24, which is... Wow, T-Bolt. That's so good. I think I can learn T-Bolt. We may as well go back and get the magnet then, and give Gengar the magnet. Let's go. I always find it really bizarre. I can't remember who it is. There's another Pokemon that can. I think it's Nidoking can learn some of the most outrageous, randomest moves. No, wrong box. No. Dax PC item withdrawal, magnet. Imagine that. Everything has come full circle. Everything's benefiting us now as well. We have the solid magnet. We can just plop onto Gengar.
Gengar.
Gen. Alright. Heal up. I think we're pretty much good. I'm just trying to think. I get one encounter, then we've got to do trainer battles as well. But the thing is, because this is the thing that makes it so difficult. It's good having a diverse team and a pretty, like, catching every single Pokemon. But also, it's very difficult because you got to take the time to level up them Pokemon as well. A Safari Ball, okay. I suppose one ball extra isn't going to hurt anyone. Silk Scarf. I would have, honestly, if all the things that I could find, obviously everyone loves Master Balls, who wouldn't love a Master Ball? I genuinely do want to That's gonna be bad. Actually did more damage than I expected. Obviously, I know it was super effective on me, but I think if it was like at least level 5, it would have easily killed. I don't know if it's a T. I'm gonna go for a cap. Go Safari Ball. Go Safari Ball. Catch me this Pokemon in the Viridian Forest. Kushti, nice. Okay, we've got a good team. We've got psychic coverage as well, which is beneficial if we ever go up against a psychic, a ghost type. Claydol. Call him Reaper. Reaper. Alright, let's go get this item. A repeat ball. This is where, like, the legendary come. Oh, wow. They've been ghastly. That's a joke. That'd have been pretty sick, to be fair. Except, can you imagine when you get, like... I don't know. Let me think. I'll go heal. What I am going to do, because obviously I want to keep camera time to... Okay, what we'll do... I don't know. We'll stick within the level caps, yeah? So I can't go higher than the gym's level, yeah? So then it saves me obviously sitting here grinding off, obviously on camera, off camera, and in an episode. I'll use the rare candies to boost our Pokemon to that specific gym. That way we can kind of get through the series quite quickly, and also it means you're having more in one episode. And that way there's always something happening. And also it's less time consuming for me as well. But those rare candies can only be applied when we're in the gym. Fair? Right. As long as this isn't a legendary, we should be fine. Oh no. He can self-destruct. How are you going to get double protect back to back? Hip it. Oh, you missed. Need you to hit. I think it might only have protect as a move, if I'm being completely honest. I definitely think that's his only move. Thank you. I just wanted to hit it because just in case, you know what I mean? The last thing I'd want to do is attack. It gets to like bare minimum and then goes kaboom and explodes on me. T-Bolt's one of the best animations ever, man. Do not care. Between that and Sword and Shield's, is it Hyper Beam? I think it's called. But yeah, that's sick. Also, you got to think, we get to... the noon. Right, I keep changing my mind throughout the series. I do apologize. Right, we're not going to use red candies. We're just going to play the game. If we have a mon that dies and it's over leveled, then so be it. We'll have like six level six monsters. I think that's how we're going to play it. So that way we're continuously pushing forward, whether we have weak mons or not. I'd have to do the switcheroo, you know, combo play. That way it's not easy and it's more of an added challenge. So... what is your ability? This is a very interesting team. Very interesting. Right, Reaper's... yeah, we'll get... yeah, let's send Reaper in. If he... mate, you can use... no, we should be fine. I can't see this being too bad. Clampearl. Oh, wow, you're level 7. Just don't have Arena Trap, man. Yeah, so we switch into Gengar. Gengar comes out. The water gun hits. We T-Bolt. It's not going to give us much XP anyway. I've just realized as well, I'm not playing hardcore, so I can beat a Pokemon, switch out, and then do it that way. Okay. That's fine. Here's Christiane. Oh. I just realized. Would Vulpix have... I don't think Vulpix would have a fire type move yet. Let's go with Tripnips. It does have Ember. Get the freeze, that'd be great. Nothing. Okay, well now we know it has the Ember. This is a little difficult. We'll go back into Reaper, eat it. We go confusion, we should be fine. Oh, I drop him defense. I shouldn't be struggling this early, man. I've been playing too many of the newer gen games that the XP all is kind of benefiting everyone else. Well, not benefiting me, should I say. Right, Tripnip's grew to level 3. Will I change my Pokemon? Let's stay in for the time being. Machoke. Okay, I'm going to go into dark because the worst you could have is probably Seismic Top. It depends. Vital Throw, Focus Energy. If I can get Hypnosis off. If he has. Oh no, we have to get Hypnosis. We have to. Oh my god, I need to switch out. I can't allow this. No. Problem is, nothing is going to eat. I'm sorry, Hench. I find it weird that the overlay changing based upon the Pokemon I'm switching out to. There we go. You're fighting, aren't you? Gonna take no chances, man. Needed that XP gain. We have to level up all these Pokemon, man. I think his highest is 14. Not that it matters, but obviously we need to get Pokeball. Wow. I need to kind of battle every trainer, but I also need to use potions. How many potions do we buy? 3, 4. Right, we'll stick with you. Put your potion on. There we go. Go with potion again. On dark. Get him up to maximum. And then we'll go battle this guy. We're going to have to battle. I think literally that's all we can do at this point. Meditate. Yeah, we'll go confusion. I'm at level 6, man. We should be fine. Okay, meditate. I should finish it with the thing. As long as its speed didn't increase, we should be fine. And then we should level up to level 7. Perfect. Mud slap, yes, because that will decrease accuracy. Rapid spin's great for, like, those moves. But I don't know if I'm going to deal with them often. Leech Seed is not a problem. Spike's not a problem. Rat Bind is a problem in this gen. But Teleport's going to be so beneficial for me in the long run. Okay, I'm going to get rid of Harden. We won't worry about defense increase. Well, the thing is, we wouldn't have to increase our defense when we're hitting with... we'll stick in. And I'll go Confusion. Ah, oh, that did some big damage. Big-ish damage, should we say. Well, I'm going to switch, because now I know you've got Headbutt. I know you can't hit Dark. But anything normal type, we're going to go into Gengar. And then Gengar can basically counter the play, and we'll just go T-Bolt. Nice. That is beautiful, ladies and gentlemen. Absolutely beautiful. Groot to level 11. I still have two trainers I think I can fight. So I'll go battle those. And there's one on the other side of here at the top. There's also... Let's run away from that and bail. Go all the way up. Cacnea. I'm just going to speed this bit up because... Yeah. Right, let's battle this guy. I think he has 6. I think he has like Caterpies and stuff. There's 3. Oh, it's randomized, isn't it? Why did I think he... Oh, my God. Oh, God. Okay. The problem I've got... He might have Dragon Rage. Right, Topo, go. Rough skin. Of all I've got is Tackle. I don't want any Pokemon to die, but I didn't expect to be dealing with a Salamence so early, if I'm being honest. I think we should be fine. I think if it was like 57, then it'd be... No. Yo, if he killed me, I'd have been mad. I would have been absolutely fuming at that. So Reaper grew to level 8. It's good because we get some big XP, so Topo should at least go to 7, maybe. No, he didn't. I'll stick him. Only for the fact that our health is quite low. Magby, and it's going to be super effective on us. I'm going to go T-Bolt. Mate, I think we'll be fine. T-Bolt is just a dominant move. Easy. I think I'm worrying too much. Worrying more than I should. Milk Tank. That is something we should worry about. I think of the moves it would have. I know it could possibly have rollout, mate. It gives me... Just giving me thingy vibes. Might have to just go Mud Slap and hope for the accuracy drop. Yeah, I'll do that. And then I'll switch back into Gengar. We have to. If... It reminds me of Goldenrod City with Whitney. With a... Pain in the ass, Milk Tank with rollout. That's the only thing. I see Milk Tank and I think rollout. We have to avoid rollout. I remember how sick she was. She was so good. So tough to counter a play. But that played off him. No, I didn't mean to lick. I went to go... Good job it was Growl because I was meant to go T-Bolt. I've just realized we still have one more trainer to beat. So, Reaper grew to 9. The way I'm thinking of this, if I can have Dark and Reaper at a decent level, doesn't Curse increase? Nah, I'm good. Take no chances. Because if that works on us and it halves my health, one attack and we're dead. No way. I'm not giving up Gengar because of a stupid curse. Gligar, okay. Not bad, not bad. Pokédoll, mate. Everything. But Safari Ball, Pokéball, Pokédoll. It's like, you not got nothing else. It's good because we can sell it, but still, it's not the point. Yeah, I'll have Dark come in. Right, okay, let's go. I think the Magnet helps, though, with the Thunderbolt massively. Esteban with a Meditate. Oh, no, no, no. This is fine. Reaper's got this. We ain't got nothing to worry about. Confusion. We're at 9-9. It's probably half damage. Just under. Man, you're going to do that move on me? You've got nothing on me. And I'll probably just finish up with a Mud Slap unless I get a crit. No. There we go. Meditate. Do-do-do. Player defeated. Okay. If we do any leveling, oh, to be fair, I might just battle Brock's trainer. But yeah, we'll save Brock's gym for the next episode, ladies and gentlemen. It's been a pleasure. Thank you all for watching. We're going to not grind. We're just going to go in and hopefully we pick up an XP share along the way. Thank you guys for watching. Take care of yourselves. See you guys next time. Peace.